Okay, good morning, everyone, and welcome to our ninth session of our subject ITAS 1. So we are now on Unit 2, and our topic for this morning is about values and references. So before we start our discussion, let me give you the objectives for this morning. So number one, we are going to explain what is object-oriented programming. Number two, we're going to explain the concepts of classes, objects, properties, methods, and events. And number three, we're going to identify values and references plus encapsulation. So we are still on object-oriented programming, and our topic is values and references. So for values and references, we have the value types, ANAI, and references types are the two main categories of C# types. So again, value types and reference types are the two main categories of C# types. So a variable of a value type contains an instance of a type. Now, this differs from a variable of a reference type, which contains references to an instance of a type. So tandaan ninyo, guys, we values and references are two different things, okay? So by default, on assignment, passing an argument to a method. So this is in programming, no? And returning a method result, variables, values are copied. So magsulat ko na kamo ka code sa value ninyo within sa compiler. This has an assignment and passing an argument to a method. So when you are going to compile, these instances of the value is being manipulated. And return value naman for the references. So the reference naman is the method result of the variable copied on the things that you did sa compiling ninyo. So more on value types, these are directly contain the data and the instances of the value types. And they are either allocated on the stack, so stack, or allocated in line in a structure. Okay, later on, we will be discussing stack, no? For the preview, magambal ka mga stack. This, ang pwede ko, guys, mahalimbawa ka dyan is, like for example, when you are going to have dinner with everyone in your family, and then sa pagkatapos nyo kaon, ginastack ninyo yung plates, yung plato ninyo bala sa lababo. So yung pinakauna magkaon, ang nakatapos, una katapos, ginabutang na yung plato na sa lababo. And then the second one, ipatong niya, ibutang na sa babaw kauna nga plato, and so on and so forth. So you will notice that for kung sino yung una nakatapos, tana orihi kaugas kapinggan, and or ana nga pinggan maugasan. And then ang sa pinakababaw, ang pinakaurihi natapos, amunda sa pinakababaw ana nga plato, amunda yung una ninyong augasan. So that is an example of a stack. And sa programming, it has similar principles wherein kung sino ang una, kung ano ang una nga data nga gin sampaw nyo, that is the ang pinakauna nga data nga nga gamiton. So those are the concept of stacking, no? Stack na siya. So that is part of your values and references, no? So for C# value types, or what we call stack. And in C#, a data type is a value type. And what it does is it holds the value of a variable. So meaning to say, it has a certain value, no, within the variable. And it is directly on in its own memory space and value types, and will use stack memory to store the values. So the example of that is when you're going to define and assign value to the variable. So like the integer, for example, x is equivalent to 1, 2, 3. And then the system will use the same memory space of the variable x to store the value 1, 2, 3. So you can see there on figure 12 that we have the value type diagram using stack. And for that, the example that we did bago lang, like int x, so you are going to declare x as an integer, so the value is 1, 2, 3. So you can see there that 1, 2, 3 is being stored on 0 times 0, 0, 4, 3, 2, 312, which is the memory address on the memory. So the memory address is found on your RAM or in your ROM. So manan yung man guro guys kung ano yung difference ka RAM kag ROM, no? So RAM is stored permanently, whereas ROM is stored temporarily. So the following, okay, so do you have any questions regarding our example? So that is true to all programming languages. So since we are using C#, so basically you are going to consider the principle that any value that is being put into place within the value type is just like our example na ginbutang natin sa figure 12. Okay, so can you follow, guys? Okay, if you can follow, kindly please raise your hand so that I will know. Okay, so very good. Okay, so thank you guys for your reaction. So let's continue our discussion. So as you can see on our screen, these are the following. The following are the different data types that will fall under value types in C. So makita niyo day 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3. 15 kabilog, no? But actually, since we are new at programming, I think ang ginagamit pa lang natin are 5 pa lang kabilog. So those are int. It stands for integer, float, floating numbers, long, char, or character, bool or boolean, byte or byte, decimal, double, enum. Enum stands for enumeration or enumerated. S-byte, short, struct, uint, ulong, and ushort. Pero I think ang ginagamit pa lang natin is ang sa first lines. So first 5 lines. So int, float, long, char, and bool. So doon mo pa lang day ay variable na ginagamit natin. Now for our activity number 15, so we have coding 115. And this one is an example of your C# value types or stacking. So this one, you can see here on coding 115 that we are still using system, or we are recalling part of the program for system. So ang declaration na kada is using system. Then for the tutlane is the namespace, meaning ang tutlane nga value, tutlane is a variable. That is a name, gineclare nyo siya as namespace. Then you have ang program, which is declared a class. Then inside it is the looping statement for static void square, integer value such as A and B. So we have the value corresponding for A and B. And this is formula of a square. And you all know that in your algebra or in your high school, mathematics, that a square, the formula of a square is a squared, no? So you're squaring the square or the value for any sides. Like for example, if the side of a square is 4 meters and you are going to square it, so the value of the square is 16, because 14 times is 14 is 16, correct? Okay, so you are going to declare it as right lines on the console, and the value of that will be displayed on the console. So you have also static void main strings for ARJS, which means that you're going to go back the value for string on a static void movement. So you start from 0, and any value that is being declared will be the value that is going to be manipulated. So we have integer, number 1 is equivalent to 5, that is fixed number, no? Later on you can change it based on our example. And int number 2 is 10. So expectedly these are added, and the output for this is being put on the console. So right line is the command for output, so that your output statement is right line. And you have the formula square, number 1, number 2. So this one. And let us see kung paano natin himuon. So we have, you're going to go for online IDE. So we are still going to use CodeChef. So since this one, our example is in C#. So basically, let's copy this first. We have actually 2 lines. Sorry. So copy, then this one, So C++, we're going to change this to C#, then paste it. Okay. So if ever we have a face-to-face class, what we're going to do, guys, is to encode it individually, no, line by line. So, but then, gusto natin dasig ang example. So we're going to copy-paste it lang. So again, ang second part is this one until sa dalom. So we're going to copy it again and paste it sugpon lang din sa dalom. So after that, you're going to run it to let us see the output. So the output is 5 to 10, 25 to 100, and 5 to 10 also. So then you're going to press the enter key for the output. Okay, so after running it, and you can actually manipulate this. So you change the value of 5 to 7, and the value of 10 to 11. So let us see if you're going to run. Expectedly, the output will be 7-11, or 49-21-21, or 7-11 also. Okay, so I think that is your activity number 15. Do you have any questions, guys, before we proceed with the reference types or C# reference types memory allocation? Do you have any questions sa activity number 15 a while ago? Okay, so if you don't have any question, can you kindly pray? Okay, thank you, Divine. So let's proceed. Okay. So our next topic is C# reference types. So it is also called your memory allocation. So memory allocation, guys, is different from stacking. And when you speak about memory allocation, this is the container of a pointer which points to another memory location that holds the data. So kanina, kung ginastore natin sa, panumduma lang ninyo, kung sa RAM natin ginastore ang stacking, ang memory allocation naman sa ROM natin siya ginastore. Okay, so let's continue. The reference type won't store the variable value directly in the memory. So instead, it will store the memory address of the variable value to indicate where the value is being stored. So in short, to make the discussion shorter, this is just buffering, no? So the very good example of this is in kung sa signal ninyo, like for example, if you open YouTube and you can see nga ang signal ninyo is mahina, you can see a dotted line nga naga-libot-libot, that is called buffering. And ang memory allocation is similar to buffering in such a way that in buffer, you still have to resume the memory nga gin utod or gin padayon lang. Like for example, hambal ko gani, kung mahina yung signal, syempre nag-loading siya. So that loading is called buffering. And that is an example of memory allocation. Hi Insa, what is the difference between your RAM and your ROM? In your RAM, in the data there that is being stored in the memory is permanently stored. So diyan doon nga daan, unless nga gin-delete ninyo. Whereas a ROM naman, which is reference type, when mag-run out lang, like for example, if you're running something on your computer, mag-run out lang golpe, then you have to start all over again. So the memory there is temporarily stored. Ang keyword is temporary. Whereas ang sa kagina, permanent ang storage. So that is an example of reference type. Compare it to value reference or value types references kagina kag ang tulad. So the example of this is the following are different data types that will fall under reference types. You have string, classes, delegates, arrays. So those are the four things that you need to remember. Again, string, class, delegates, and arrays. Now, if the value type contains the data member of a reference type, it only means that there is a reference type to the instance of the reference type that is being copied on the value type instance. So both value type and reference type have access to the same reference type instance. Now, unlike the value type, the reference type doesn't store its value directly, whereas naga-temporary store siya. So ang ginatawag natin nga buffering balahaw. So the keyword there is buffering. Okay, so the example of reference type is found on activity number 16, and it is called your coding 116. So we are going to still use C#, and using namespace as a value declaration for the variable or the library being declared. The namespace there for the C# examples, and we are going to use classes. Ang variable natin is person and program. So whereas the person, we have integer age, meaning ang age nga value is declared as an integer. And the class as the program as class, wherein you have the value for static void square. So you have person A and person B, and the formula for age is this one. Then the formula for age is declared on the console, and it is also have a formula for person, which is also displayed on the console. So let us see, no? Copy this one. Then paste it sa dang ano nato, no? Ang kagina naton bala nga ano. Then ang sugpon, i-copy ba naton la siya liwat. Ang second part. Okay, so we're going to press run. Now the output will be this one. 5, 10, 25, 10, 25, 10. So press any key to exit. Now it will be executed after you press the exit button. To manipulate this, you're going to change also this one on the P1 age. So you have to change 7, then 11, for example. Or you can change it to another value if you want. Then run the program. And this one is the answer. So more or less, they are similar, medyo pareho. Or different man gyapon in such a way nga ang value nga in-declare ninyo dyan is different. Ang variable, kag ang pamaagi kung paano niya gin-obra. So panramdaman lang ninyo, if you're going to compare ang kaginang example, that is directly manipulating the memory. For the second one, you are buffering or storing the memory on a temporary storage. So the ano day ang kinalain. So stacking is for RAM, and reference type is for ROM. So that is the difference between the two. Okay? Okay, so I think that is all for the for our discussion, guys. I think we're going to stop to present so that I can see who's the attending our class this morning, no. So I'm sorry for the delay because I still have to give exam to fourth year sandang subject pa kanang nagligan nga semester. So guys, I'm going to give your midterm exam already next meeting, or I will not post an activity next week, but I'm going to give you your exam. So ano lang natin sa time. Okay? I don't know if I can give the exam at the other sections on time. That is because that is after the election on May 9 siguro, no. Pero if ever I can give them on May 10, that will be better. So the reason I'm going to give the exam ahead, although why pag in-announce ko saan yung midterm natin, is because naka-adto lang kita sa 9th week na. So deliberately, I'm not going to wait for the midterm announcement. But so that you can prepare your exam sa other subjects ninyo. And of course, I already prepared your exams already. So I'm going to give you the exam next week na. Ha? So I think that is 90 items only. You can answer it in 1.5 hours, probably to 1.5 hours to 2 hours. So sa time lang natin, guys, manounce man ako gyapon sa ng GC nyo kung saan o i-exam natin. Most probably, I will give your midterm exam next week na. So I'm not going to wait for the announcement ka eskulahan. Just because understood doon nga half do kita ka ano naton ka semester. Haiti 9 weeks doon mo. Yeah, lesson naton. So sunod-sunod nga 9 weeks and wait atot palya sa activity ta. And sa mga lesson naton sa Google Classroom, I think so you please study your lesson and if ever you have answered the quizzes, so there's no problem, no. So the coverage of our examination will be starting from the very beginning until ang last topic naton. So most of the time that is on programming. So the good news is exam ninyo, it's multiple choice. So 90 items multiple choice, there's no problem. And I'm not going to give you a coded exam, meaning ang encoding ninyo tanas sa activity lang da. So we are now more on principles and multiple choices. So I think there's no problem. So do you have any question, guys? Inquiry about the things that we discussed this morning? May pamangkot ka mo, guys? Okay, so just prepare for... Yes, Javine? Hindi ka mo maguyo.
Why, sir?
Okay, sige. So, hindi ka mo maghuya-huya mangkot or clarification because so that we can remedy the things that is bothering you or kung ano, malasolusyon na natin. So, next week lang kita. May exam kita doon guys, ha? Midterm. Just prepare 1 to 90 items, multiple choice. Online man gyapon exam nato na, so you don't need to come here at school. But make sure that you have enough load. Kay there's a problem regarding the connectivity and sa pagbuol ka exam. Hay ang mga students ko based on experience, sometimes when hindi sanda katapos or hindi ka ano. So I think base madura balaya ano nyo, maliwat ka muliwat ka buol. So our exam is timed, guys. I'm going to give you 90 minutes, no? So 30 minutes plus another ano, that will be 1 hour and a half. So that is 90 minutes, no? I think if I'm not mistaken. It's all good, no? Review the things that you have in your quizzes. Because most of the time, I will get the exam sa quizzes ninyo. Okay? Okay, so thank you very much, guys, for attending our class this morning. And I appreciate your attendance following the quick announcement. So let me have a screenshot first. That will be for your attendance. Okay, so thank you very much for attending our class. And good morning sa tanan.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, thank you,
morning, sir.
Morning, yes, sir. Jan. Okay, thank you, Enrique. Good morning. Thank you. Sige, bye-bye, guys. See you next meeting. If ever you have concerns, bye-bye, you sir. Can actually PM me on the, or in our chat box sa GC. You can ask questions there later. Okay, so thank you and good morning.
Yes, sir, thank you.
Sir.